Hi, welcome back to the product image search learning pathway, where you can learn how to let your users take a photo and search for visually similar products in your product catalog. This is the second video in the learning pathway, and we'll learn how to build an on-device object detector. When an user captures an image using their phone camera, we want them to tell us which object in the image that they want to search for in our product catalog. We do so by first detecting objects in the image, then second, shows the detection result on the screen, and finally, lets the user choose the object that they want to search for. We will implement the object detector by using MLKit's Object Detection and Tracking API. MLKit provides many easy-to-use APIs to integrate machine learning into your mobile app without any machine learning expertise required. To keep everything simple and focus on the machine learning parts of the app, we'll start with a skeleton app that already has a lot of boilerplate UI code. The app can take photos using a phone camera, or it can also load images from the phone's photo album. Next, we'll add code to do object detection. We start with adding MLKit to the app dependency. Go to the build.gradle file and add this line. Then next, go to the main activity and find this method. The starter app is implemented so that whenever you pick an image, either by taking photo using the camera app or selecting one from the preset images, this method will be called. Let's add object detection code to this method. There are only three steps to use the MLKit Object Detection API. First, you need to create an input image from the image that the user has selected. Next, you need to create an object detection client. Here we specify a few options. We detect objects from a still image, so we use single image mode. We expect that there will be multiple objects in the image, so we enable the multiple objects option. And finally, we also enable the classification option because we want to know what kind of object has the model detected, and filter out only the objects that we are interested in. In this case, we want to detect only fashion items. Then we feed the input image to the detector and print the detection result to look at. Let's take a closer look at the code that prints the detection result. You can see that the Object Detection API returns a list of detected objects, each representing an object that it found in the input image. In each detected object, there's a bounding box or rectangle showing where the object is located in the input image. And there's also multiple labels indicating which type of object it is. There's a confidence score indicating how confident the model is when it says the object is of that type. Okay, now let's run the app. You can see that in this image, the model can detect one fashion good and where it is in the image. It's 94% confident about the detection. Okay, so now you know how to detect objects with MLKit. Very easy, isn't it? Next, we'll draw the detection result on the app UI so that the user can select the object that they want to search for. There's already a method implemented in the starter app that does this for you. You just need to pass the bounding boxes of the objects to the method. Let's run the app again. You can see that a white dot shows up where the object is detected. Now, users can select the object that they want to search for by tapping on the dot. And that's it. You can go to the code lab following this video in the learning pathway to download the source code and go through the steps that I have just shown you. And last but not least, design is a crucial factor to build a good app. So we have published material design guidelines on how an object detection interface should be like. Please check them out from the links in the learning pathway. In the next video, we'll look into how we can search for visually similar products by sending the detected object to a product search backend built with Vision API product search. Thank you for watching.